Genesis chapter 11. And the whole earth is of one language and of the same words. And it comes to pass in their journeying from the east that they find a valley in the land of Shinar and dwell there. And they each say to his neighbor, Give help, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly. And the brick is to them for stone, and the bitumen has been to them for mortar. And they say, Give help, let us build for ourselves a city and tower with its head in the heavens, and make for ourselves a name, lest we be scattered over the face of all the earth. And Yahweh comes down to see the city and the tower which the sons of men have built. And Yahweh says, Behold, the people is one, and one language is to them all. And this it has dreamed of doing, and now nothing is restrained from them of that which they have purposed to do. Give help. Let us go down there and confuse their language, so that a man will not understand the language of his companion. And Yahweh scatters them from there over the face of the earth, and they cease to build the city. Therefore one has called its name Babel, for there Yahweh has confused the language of all the earth, and from there Yahweh has scattered them over the face of all the earth. These are the generations of Shem. Shem is a son of 100 years, and begets Arphaxad 2 years after the flood. And Shem lives after his begetting Arphaxad 500 years, and begets sons and daughters. And Arphaxad has lived 35 years, and begets Selah. And Arphaxad lives after his begetting Selah 403 years, and he begets sons and daughters. And Selah has lived 30 years, and begets Eber. And Selah lives after his begetting Eber 403 years, and begets sons and daughters. And Eber lives 34 years, and begets Peleg. And Eber lives after his begetting Peleg 430 years, and begets sons and daughters. And Peleg lives 30 years, and begets Reu. And Peleg lives after his begetting Reu 209 years, and begets sons and daughters. And Reu lives after his begetting Serug 207 years, and begets sons and daughters. And Serug lives 30 years, and begets Nahor. And Serug lives after his begetting Nahor 200 years, and begets sons and daughters. And Nahor lives 29 years, and begets Terah. And Nahor lives after his begetting Terah 119 years, and begets sons and daughters. And Terah lives 70 years, and begets Abram, Nahor, and Haran. And these are the generations of Terah. Terah has begotten Abraham, Nahor, and Haran. And Haran has begotten Lot. And Haran dies in the presence of Terah his father, in the land of his birth, in Ur of the Chaldees. And Abram and Nahor take to themselves wives. The name of Abram's wife is Sarai, and the name of Nahor's wife is Milcah, daughter of Haran, father of Milcah, and father of Iscah. And Sarai is barren, she has no child. And Terah takes his son Abram, and Lot, son of Haran, his son's son, and his daughter-in-law Sarai, wife of his son Abram. And they go out with them from Ur of the Chaldees, to go toward the land of Canaan. And they come to Haran, and dwell there. And the days of Terah are 205 years, and Terah dies in Haran.